One of the big things I'm seeing in my clients this week is I don't have enough confidence. And I want to address this big, I use the word mistake, but it's really a misconception about confidence and what that really means and how to get it. So let me give you a few examples. In my coaching group this week, one of my clients, and remember, we're all on a group call together, and the best part of being on a group call is one person's talking about her stuff. And everybody else on the call is going, oh my God, yes, I totally understand. So she knows she's not the only crazy one dealing with whatever the thing is. This particular client was talking about, she's got two paths that she can go down to grow her business. And she's got this one path where she's like an expert. And if you could have heard her voice when she was talking about it, she was just like, yeah, I could do that, blah, 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 blah. I've done it for a really long time and I'm an expert. But there was no passion behind it. There was no excitement. And then I said, okay, well, what's your second option? And she started talking about this other path that she could go down, which she has not done yet. And she's not an expert at that path. But when she talked about it, she was like, bah, 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 and I know I could solve this problem. And this is how I imagine solving the problem. And these are the kinds of things I could offer. Like, her energy was really up here, like super, super excited. And I said, okay, well, what's in your way? And she's like, well, I don't know how to do that one. I've never done it before. I'm not an expert. There's many more people out there doing it, you know, with more training. I hear this all the time. Women are saying to me, I want this thing. I need more training. I need another certification. I need to practice more. What they are saying to me and what this client said to me in this call was, I'm just waiting for the confidence so I can put this program together. Until then, I'm just gonna kind of circle the drain over here, feeling very meh and not very interested and kind of going through the motions, no passion, just like kind of doing the thing that she feels, you know, confident doing. She's waiting for the confidence to do this, the thing that excites her. I see this every day. And what I want you to know, the mistake that we all make, this is not just my client, I've done this too. We are waiting for the confidence. We tell ourselves, well, when I feel confident, then I will take action. So what do my clients love to do? Well, before they're my clients, once they're my clients, I don't let them do this anymore. So what do my clients love to do before I get my hands on them? Let me take another training. Let me buy another course. How many freaking courses do you have living on your computer? Let me talk to somebody about it. Let me consider, maybe should I get a partner? Like, these are all the ways that we keep ourselves small because we are waiting to feel confident. And my friends, we have it backwards. It doesn't happen that way. It's not that we get more training and then we feel confident. We get confidence from doing the thing. We get confidence from just starting. Are you going to suck when you start? Maybe. You're probably not going to be as good as you're going to be a year from now and 2 years from now. I want you to think back 10 years ago when you started whatever you're doing right now. I bet it was hard. I bet you weren't very good at it, right? And that's totally normal. Like, you don't go to kindergarten on the first day and you're like, I've got this school thing down. I know how to read. No, 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 no. You go and maybe you cling to your mom's leg and you're like, what's happening? Why is this lady telling me what to do all day long? And every single day you get a little bit better. And before you know it, you've graduated high school and then you repeat the thing at college and maybe grad school. But it's not the education that gives us the confidence. It's the going through the stuff and dealing with the shit that gives us the confidence. And if you are sitting at home, online, taking more courses on your computer, or you're waiting to feel confident, I promise you, you will never grow your business. You will stay circling the drain where you are right now. Let me give you another example from my clients. I have a huge success story. I'm going to share it next month with you. I'm very excited about this particular client. And she's given me permission to talk about her, which is wonderful. And she, at this time last year, was absolutely hiding from herself. She was terrified to put herself out there. She was terrified to be on social media. She thought nobody wanted to listen to her. So we've been working together for a year. Well, we've been working together for more than a year. And we worked together privately. And last night was her last private session before she goes into her continuity program with me. And like, the transformation is 180 degrees. She shows up. She does not hide anymore. Do you know how she, her She has a parent company. She sells jewelry, and the parent company that she sells for, they use her and her feed as training for other people in the company. This is a woman who 1 year ago could not even show up for our coaching calls because she was so terrified. She didn't have the confidence, right? She didn't believe she could do it. She's like, I need more training. I need to get confidence before I do this. I'm like, that's not the way it works. You go through and that's how you get the confidence. Well, this woman in a year has completely transformed her business, and it happens slowly. That's the thing. People want it to be like overnight. And there are all these coaches out there who are selling you like the six-figure promise and the seven-figure promise. And are those valid for a lot of people? Sure, but they might not be you might not be ready for that. If you're making $0 in your business right now, to go from zero to six figures is a terrifying thought that your brain can't wrap itself around. That's not your fault. If you don't feel confident right now, that's not your fault. You don't know how to do this, that's not your fault. I bet you're a practitioner of something amazing. I bet you're really great at what you do, but you might not know how to grow a business. That's not your fault. You know what is your fault? Staying right where you are. That's where you start to say, how much of this am I to blame? How much am I not moving forward? How much am I not taking action? I know that it's scary. If you keep waiting for the confidence, it will never come. You have to create the confidence, and it can be done. I have witnessed it. This is not bullshit for other people. This is for you. I promise you. So, if you are somebody who wants a business that looks different than your business looks today, or you want a life that looks different than it looks today, because how you do business and how you do life, they're very similar, then you need to take action, even if it's scary. That's the definition of courage. You are scared and you do it anyway. You might suck at it. It might be hard. You're certainly going to be uncomfortable. You might need support. I'm telling you, you're not alone. This is the story I hear every day. And if you are waiting for confidence to, I don't know, knock at your door, ding dong, ditch you or something, there, it's not going to happen. How's it going to happen? By you taking action. So I encourage you, what action are you going to take today? It's going to feel scary. You might not know all the hows. That's okay. You don't have to know all the hows. What you have to know is, what's your very next step? Is it doing a little bit of research? I bet it's not taking a course. I will let you know that 90% of people who sign up for an online course do not finish it. And there's lots of research on that. And that's okay, because for some people, getting the course and taking that 10% is the thing that gets them going. But for you, if you need to figure out the how to get yourself going, and you need support, and you want to be around other people because you're currently surrounded by people who don't believe in you, and that only makes you not believe in yourself, then please reach out to me. It's literally why I designed the Idea Space. It's a group of women who are just like you. They're purpose-driven, they are heart-centered, they want to build a business that works for their life. They don't want to be eaten up by their business. They don't want to work 70 hours a week. And I promise you, you don't have to. So if this sounds appealing to you, please reach out to me. You can email me, you can PM me, you can get in touch with me. I'll put all the links below. But you can start, and you don't have to wait for, your kids to go back to school, for your husband to give you permission. You don't have to wait for anything to get started now. And so I encourage you, take some action, and know that it will be scary and you're going to do just fine. I hope this is helpful. Please share this with somebody who you think really could use this message. And if that is you, then I'd love to hear from you. Thanks. Bye.